Fine. So what do you like most about Kashmir?
I like the relationship I have with the people.
Do you plan on getting married?
Yeah, I mean, I don't plan it, but if it happens...
So please do invite us that day. Yeah.
That I can arrange right now.
She's here?
She's here?
No, she's not here, but...
And also the bond you share, I just love that. I tell my brother, he sometimes, you know, teases me.
Oh, so then I'm like, oh, you know what I'll do? I'll go and meet some Kashmiri... Kashmiri youngsters, talk to them. So now my work will become more interesting. Hello. How are you?
How are
nice
you?
To meet you?
It's nice to meet
Hello,
you.
Sir.
It's a dream come true.
Hi.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Hello, how are you?
How are you, sir?
I always like coming to Kashmir. How are you, ladies?
Yeah, fine. So what do you like most about Kashmir?
I like the relationship I have with the people. I like the place always.
People admire you here.
People here are having such a hard time.
Yes.
And, you know, struggling. And I feel bad. So if I can do something for that a little bit, then I try and see if I can. Of course, it's beautiful also. How does the situation here disturb your plans?
Does it stress you out? You
it feel stresses
worried?
A lot.
It disturb how?
I never wanted to continue my studies here because it's so depressing. I wanted to go outside, but then my parents didn't let me. So I had to stay here and... But political science, I wanted to do it. I was passionate about it, so I did it.
But you know, my experience with political science, studying political science, is what they teach you in university is nothing to do with
the real
politics.
Nothing. Like, it's just nothing. They are in some other world.
That's the sad part.
And the politics is in some other world.
That's
so
the sad part.
International relations as well?
Yeah.
From which one?
Harvard?
From Harvard University. Then after that, Papa died, so then I had to go to Rollins College,
okay.
And then from there I went to Cambridge University in England.
You also did your master's?
From your childhood, so you wanted to become a politician and you had other dreams?
Not when I was small.
But after Papa died, I felt that I should... I saw Papa's death as someone stopping him from doing what he wanted or what work he wanted to do. So then I got that idea. We say, oh, I want to change that, I want to change that, I want to change that. You don't realize that to change any of that, you have to change this.
We also want to be free and chase our dreams.
But you know, there's one thing that I try to find happiness in whatever I'm doing. Maybe it's forced. So if I'm doing my work, then I'll try to be happy in that. And then how will I be happy in that? How do you think I'll be happy in that? My work is quite tedious and serious.
Because you like it.
No, so then I'll like, oh, you know what I'll do? I'll go and meet some Kashmiri, Kashmiri youngsters, talk to them. So now my work will become more interesting. So I try, whatever I'm doing, I try to find something nice to do.
We also want to do a lot of things, but because of the condition or because of the lack of opportunities, we can't.
Yeah.
Like being Kashmiri woman, I know what kind of problems I face. Like we have less literacy rate in Kashmir.
Yeah.
We have less employment rate.
And like, we have also less representation.
The unemployment rate of women in Kashmir, it's 76%. If being a physicist, I see only one female professor in Kashmir.
So how do you see the press freedom in Kashmir?
I see huge problems with the press freedom in Kashmir and in the rest of the country.
Well.
My view about the Prime Minister, my problem with him is that he doesn't listen to anybody, number one.
Yeah.
And number two, I have a problem with somebody who from the beginning believes that they're right. Even if he's seeing something that is showing him that what he's saying is wrong, he will not accept that. So then that type of a person will always create some problem or the other. I think it comes from insecurity. It doesn't come from strength. It comes from weakness. No, so how do you... You're saying that women are discriminated.
Yeah, unemployment.
You're saying education is...
Backward.
Limited backward.
I went for an internship to Delhi through a fellowship. When I met there an NLU student, he was from NLU Raipur and he was in his second year. I just shared it with them also. In his second year, it was his fourth or fifth internship. And I was in my fourth year and it was my first internship. And he was shocked. Because herein, we don't have any corporate firms, we don't have MNCs, so we lack opportunities. We are far behind them. So that's also a problem here. There are emerging fields like we have corporate law, banking law, sports law, or cyber law. So we lack those things. We are not able to explore the new things here.
Now you're talking about university, college. I also want to understand how does it work with your regular life? In your home, with your friends, how is it different?
The extracurricular activities and sports, wo bhi nahi hai na utna acha yahan pe. That is also not that great.
We want to go in sports.
But kya karte ho?
We have a lot of positive things as well. We have experienced good childhood. We have experienced like We can play sports. It depends on personality. Now, some girls may not be very much interested. Otherwise,
you play sports?
Yeah.
What do you play?
I play tennis. I play golf as well.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
And
so
you?
I play swimming.
Badminton.
And badminton.
So
and
I would like to ask.
Basketball.
Achha, everything.
Yeah. We play, but on like personal level. But we also want to do it. Like
so
we
like
also
to
want to represent our country somewhere.
Our
but
country.
We are not given the avenues.
Basically, whatever is happening. So how do you see your government can change?
I was talking to my mother
the
yesterday.
The women's security.
And my mother was saying the problem is a societal problem. There is a legal problem,
mm-hmm.
but the problem is the attitude of men towards women. That's
right.
The real problem. If you don't view them as equal, if you don't give them respect. Then
so
this
so you
is the
believe
title.
It starts with education first
yeah.
and awareness within the society.
That's why I was talking about like we should have
our education people. System, in my view, does absolutely nothing to help this issue.
Okay.
Right?
So
I
fact.
I don't think so. I mean
fact.
Have you you know
so
I,
do you think so introducing new courses in the like primary school maybe for gender education or other women's safety things?
I think that would help, but I think it's much more a change in society.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah. Here is lack of awareness.
Lack of understanding. Do you think they feel women are inferior?
Yeah.
They
that's
do.
How
huh?
we are.
Mm-hmm. Is it that they think women are inferior or is it that they think women are good at other things?
No,
they think they're inferior.
Yeah.
I would not agree with that. No, so how is it with your parents? Are they worried all the time? Are they stressed out?
There is not a single day when I don't meet a woman
yeah.
who will complain of a harassment in a public
transport.
So the only thing is what scares them is that they don't want to report.
So we noted this only happened after 2019.
Yeah.
So
every single day we'll see a police.
I'm telling you.
Everything is checked here, right? So that it's not possible there's something as big as that is happening and you know the government cannot control.
Right.
Elections are coming,
but there's no statehood.
Yeah, exactly.
So what, I mean, you know.
Even that is so
how
depressing.
Do you see the restoration of statehood? Do you
I
see
think
it's
it should
positive?
Be. I think it's the first time in Indian history
that
statehood
yeah.
has been taken away from somebody.
Somebody.
Yeah. It's never exactly. happened before. But we are pretty clear that the nature, the way it was done, we did not like. But for us now, the principle is get the representation back, get the statehood back.
Yeah.
And that includes, you know, representation to people of Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh. And this status of running Kashmir, running Jammu from Delhi, it doesn't make any sense.
Totally.
And it's frankly taking away huge opportunity from the people.
Exactly.
Of Jammu.
That's
yeah.
why we are so sad.
So how do you see the changing politics all over in India?
So if you start to believe that you're God, and then one fine day you find out, no, you're not God, you're a human being, then you got a problem. Opposition played a very solid role over the last 3-4 years,
right.
which changed a lot of people's minds saying that bhai ye theek nahi hai. But I think we're coming to the end of that, you know,
every
peak ho gaya.
Also meet with Priyanka ma'am, your sister.
You want to meet her?
Yeah.
That I can arrange right now.
She's here?
No, she's not here. But
and also the bond you share, I just love that. I tell my brother, he sometimes, you know, teases me or fights with me.
I tease her, don't worry. Hello. Put on your video. I've got some ladies here who want to say hi to you.
Hi. How are you, ma'am?
Good. How are you?
We're good. You should be here in Kashmir. Why are you not here?
Exactly.
You should be here.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
So I just arrived late last night.
Oh. You tell her to come.
You can still come. You
today?
Can come. Today or
yeah.
any day.
Now
whenever you're
coming
free.
Home today.
Yeah. We will make him stay one more day.
No, you should come here and meet
her. I'll come back with him next. Me come.
Yes, ma'am. Do
yes.
come. We'll
you
be waiting
need me
for
to
you.
Come. You can come on your own also.
I'll do that.
We'll be waiting for you,
what
ma'am.
Doing?
We're having a conversation with him.
I hope you're able to have a good, honest conversation.
Yes,
yes
we are enjoying it. We're enjoying
They're
it.
They're bullying me.
No.
He's bullying us.
Oh.
What about marriage pressure?
Oh, I don't want to get married anytime soon.
Are you talking about the society or a person?
She's trying to get me into trouble.
What do you think about that? What are your thoughts?
I've outlasted that pressure for 20-30 years.
Do you
but
plan?
I think it's a good thing.
Do you plan on getting married?
Yeah, I mean, I don't plan it, but if it happens...
So please do invite us that day. Yeah. So because you need to know.
Like, I am only 21. What's happening in the society. I'm only 21. I'm living my years. You know, I'm just trying to be chill. I don't want to grow up anymore because I don't want to get married. So it is scary, you know. It is a bit scary.
Why?
I don't know. Marriage, it feels
overwhelming. I was in the court last time for our court diary and I saw the divorce rates in Kashmir are increasing like anything. So that's better to not get married for at least jitna time of avoid kar
until you find the right person. But woh abhi tak mil nahi raha hai.
We have marriage pressure going on in our society and families. Yeah. Like any girl who crosses 12th or graduates. And the next step is, when are you getting married?
Yeah.
So when we look at a societal level, lack of delay in marriages is actually lack of employment also.
Yeah.
Because men, when they don't get employed, until they're re-employed, they can't get married. So that's a lot of societal level pressure on the men also. So lack of employment is a major cause.
Indian women, what's your message for Indian women?
Please come up and avail the opportunities.
Come out, explore.
Right now they are fighting for a security and they expect it from the government.
Yeah.
It is like on a personal level, societal level, you would see it, you should not do that. But what is the government doing to secure? There are other countries as well this happens. There should be more strict laws. There should be more implementation of those laws.
We should like look into the harassment women are facing. That's not reported. Like in any workplace, in any institute. Harassments are everywhere. I want, like, there should be protection for girls, security. Like, we should also feel safe. We don't feel safe.